Astronomers began to recognize in the 1930s that the universe seemed to contain unseen things that behaved like matter. For example, clumping via gravitational attraction was detected. By the 1970s, several kinds of data confirmed this. The most compelling came from the rotational velocity of stars in spiral galaxies. Newtonian gravity implies that the rotational velocity at a distance r from the galactic center is given by v, where g is Newton's constant and mr is the amount of mass contained inside the orbit. For a fixed amount of mass inside larger orbits, one would expect the velocity to decrease like 1 over the square root of r, but in fact measurements show v to be approximately constant, so that mr is increasing linearly with distance. This is what would happen if the galaxies were actually spherical halos of dark matter, with stars concentrated in flatter disks. The fraction of mass energy of the universe in the universe can be estimated from studies of galaxy and galaxy cluster rotation velocity data. The part that is normal matter has a sharp upper limit from the success of Big Bang nucleosynthesis and other data, and is less than about 5%. The dark matter is about 25% of the total mass energy. By the early 1980s, people were becoming convinced that the dark matter could not be ordinary matter in the form of, say, many Jupiters, but would instead have to be a new form of matter. Three candidates had emerged, particles that had been proposed to exist for reasons unrelated to dark matter. Those candidates were axions, neutrinos, and the lightest superpartner, LSP, if the Standard Model had a supersymmetric extension.